This is the Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region of China, located in the far northwest of the country, bordering Mongolia and Kazakhstan. Stretching across a vast area of over 618,000 square miles, Xinjiang is known for its dry meadows, towering mountains, and deserts. In fact, it's one of the driest and most remote places on Earth, with less than 10% of the land being livable. No sea in sight. And Urumqi, its capital, holds the record for being the farthest city from any ocean. It's a place that many would think is inhospitable, even desolate. But this is the exact spot where China decided to release millions of fish and crabs into the desert. Sounds crazy, right? Let's find out why. We're talking about the heart of the Taklamakan Desert, often called the Sea of Death. It's a brutal place where rainfall is scarce. The evaporation rate is high, and sandstorms rage constantly. For years, this harsh environment made it nearly impossible to live here. But something incredible happened recently. With just a few taps on a control panel, local aquaculture was born in the middle of this hostile desert. Today, 100,000 seafish fry were released into specially designed ponds. These include species like golden sea bream, groupers, and even mudskippers. Within moments, they darted through the water, competing for food, bringing life to an area that had seen only sand for centuries. You might be wondering, how did these fish survive such extreme conditions? Remarkably, the fish adapted to their new environment very quickly. Survival rates hit 99% thanks to careful breeding and innovation. Today, the impact is huge. Tens of thousands of locals now work in the aquaculture industry. In fact, in 2016, the average income of Xinjiang's fishermen was 16,600 yuan, about $2,300, which was significantly higher than what local farmers earned. Now hold on, this is a desert. How on earth did they manage to get enough water to raise fish? Well, here's where it gets interesting. On the northwest edge of the Taklamakan Desert, there are 707 acres of saline alkaline water, part of a protected area. And surprisingly, there are also rivers, lakes, and reservoirs. Despite the dry climate, Xinjiang has 2,100 square miles of water bodies, some of which are home to tiny organisms that can feed the fish. But here's the catch. The water is extremely salty. For years, it was considered useless for farming. The soil in the area was also saline and alkaline, making it difficult to grow anything. Yet, China found a way to turn these disadvantages into opportunities. The key breakthrough came at Hangqi Farm. They began experimenting with farming seafish in this saline water. After extensive research, scientists discovered that adding calcium, magnesium, and potassium ions to the saline water made it resemble seawater without harming human health. This created a suitable environment for seafish to thrive. And just like that, they had artificial seawater for farming fish in the desert. This innovation led to several patents, opening up new possibilities for various species to be farmed here. By 2017, the government started pushing for more investments in aquaculture, aiming to transform Xinjiang into a major hub for fish and seafood production. Today, seafood produced here is used in restaurants across China, and some of it is even exported. Fast forward to 2023, and Xinjiang's aquaculture industry has reached new heights. They produced 184,000 tons of products worth $530 million. And by 2025, experts predict that the industry's total value could soar to nearly $3 billion. At this point, six cooperatives and businesses are actively farming fish, crabs, and even shrimp. They've already raised 414,000 fish of 8 species, 305,000 green crabs, and 4.8 million shrimp. Xinjiang's aquaculture isn't just limited to fish. It's also home to a wide range of marine life, including shrimp, tilapia, lobsters, and even salmon. In 2023 alone, Boston Lake set a new record with a harvest of over 4,000 tons of crabs. But here's where it gets even more surprising. They're now farming pearls in the desert. Yes, pearls in the middle of the Taklamakan Desert. The unique desert climate, with its extreme temperature fluctuations and abundant sunshine, has proven to be perfect for farming marine organisms like pearl oysters. In 2023, 2 million pearl oysters were successfully farmed, and by 2025, they're set to begin selling their first batch of pearls. In 2023, online sales of aquatic products in Xinjiang reached $54 million, a staggering 106% increase from the previous year. It's incredible, isn't it? Who would have thought that the arid, barren Taklamakan Desert could become home to a thriving aquaculture industry? But that's exactly what's happening in Xinjiang. Thanks to innovation, investment, and a little bit of daring, this region is turning into an unlikely seafood hub. So next time you hear about fish being farmed in the desert, just remember, it's not so impossible after all. What do you think is the most surprising thing about farming seafood in the middle of a desert? Let me know in the comments below. And don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing content. See you in the next video.